Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm trying to repair a flight controller. From what I have seen on the internet, it is called Cicada 430 amp plus an F4 omnibus with OSD flight controller all in one. Everything is super duper extra all in one. If I didn't tell you by now, I hate all in one stuff. All in one flight controllers without a PDB I can take, but PDB and flight controller and no OSD and in this case ESC is a nightmare really, because there is a limit on how much things you can cramp into such a little space, and it's mostly about noise and reliability and a lot of other stuff. This flight controller, I personally don't like it. It's designed with a fit, in my opinion. Everything is pretty badly placed. Enough with my talks. The flight controller itself, it's working, but the ESC section has an issue on this motor output. And also here we have a missing cap. And if you didn't know by now, on ESCs, most of the time, the caps, they are in series, 2, 3, 4 caps or more in series to increase the capacitance, because if you go up in voltage, the actual capacitance goes lower, so they need to have a bigger capacitance. So I will need to place here a cap. Let's just hope that there is some pad left here. Here at least I have a pad. But what about this one here? But from what I see, we are lucky. Clean up the pads a bit. Just to make sure they are clean. And clean the area a bit. I have here part of the cap actually. Taking this out and finding myself a donor board. If you watched my airbutt repair video, you know that from here I took out some MOSFETs, and I will also steal some caps from here. I will have to wait a bit because the board has a lot of copper and it takes a while until it gets to the right temperature to melt the solder. Now it's getting close, but not quite there yet. I'm sensing the water, so to speak. Okay, so we found ourselves a cap, and to solder it in place I will use some solder paste. So we place our cap into the bead of solder paste, heating up from a distance, and we will see the cap soldered to the pads. It's not the best alignment, but I guess it will do. This cap is just dirty. I will clean it in the end. But what I want to do now is just find out if one of the other MOSFETs from this motor are in short to the positive or negative. So that means that the pair on this motor lead, meaning this MOSFET, is also dead. So I will take that out also. And I will put some flux here, heating up. Okay, so this MOSFET is killed. I will take this board out for now and prepare the donor board, which is a generic Chinese ESC. It's been sold on so many brands that it's quite difficult to know exactly which company did this. I know for a fact that all these MOSFETs are good, so I will take out only two, because we have to replace two on that Cicada flight controller. This board will be way easier to heat up and take out the MOSFETs, because it's thinner and it has a little mass. Every time it's easier to heat up and reflow little boards. As I told you, to be honest, I will not bother cleaning that flux from there. I'm just gonna retouch this one as it is. Heating it up pretty hard to get it to reach the required temperature for reflowing. Okay, now I will prepare an ear stick and try and clean a bit from here. This FC has a lot of gunk here, remains, I don't know from where. This is how I received this FC, with all this gunk here. On this side I will clean, because I don't like how it looks. Here I had an exploded MOSFET, and let's hope I can place the replacement MOSFET without any issues. Same procedure, flux. And of course heating, a lot of heating. This is the funny thing with Chinese made electronics. Most of them use the same components. Come on, little MOSFET. Solder down. Good. Now we are waiting a little for it to cool down, and with the help of a toothbrush we will clean the hell out of it. Now to wrap it up and now that we done a good job, I'm gonna take my test motor and hook it up to that motor lead, the one that had one missing MOSFET and the other one was in short. It's clean enough. Taking my power supply, hook it up. At least in theory, we should hear the starting beep of the BL-Heli ESC code, and that would be the sign that we managed to repair it. Now for really testing it and not assume it's okay even if we heard the beeps, I went into the Betaflight GUI and activated the motor testing option. So the motor is also working. Shutting everything down. I hope this video helped you guys, and please subscribe to my channel if you didn't do it by now, and see you next time.